It was fortunate that I got a scholarship to go to Haverford and lasted there until the middle of my junior year, at which time I was expelled for high misdemeanors of involved with a conspiracy to commit panty raids at Bryn Mawr and to disrupt their May Day celebration, which turned out to be an unwanted Haverford tradition that was vigorously inveighed against by the president of the college that would warn us that they would not rescue us if we were captured and imprisoned. But I was part of a contingent of 10 who were arrested across the street from the Bryn Mawr campus. This was in 1954, and I was really sweating the draft because it was in full force in the Cold War. So I rapidly got admitted to Guilford College, another Quaker college, but sort of like the brand X of the Quakerism that I knew. I knew the sort of like intellectual, non-programmatic, urban, eastern population corridor, relatively intellectual Quakers that were quite a different breed from the fundamentalists that I met at Guilford, where I guess I was wise to hide the pint of whiskey that I brought with me upon my arrival and learned that it was completely forbidden on campus, and that nicotine was also forbidden for women on campus, and that men could only smoke in certain locations. And so it was more of a go-along, get-along ethos that I felt very stultified in. Was very fortunate that I was able to get accepted at Reed College. Reed was the great adventure that saw me hitchhiking across the country with one suitcase and my guitar. I really enjoyed Reed College because I guess I was ready to apply myself and fix on a goal because of my failure and washing out of the world at Haverford and realizing that Guilford would not be my kind of people that I would feel comfortable with. But when I got to Reed, I thought, aha, this is what I like. The relationships also with the faculty and students was different. At Haverford and Guilford, there was a definite standoffishness. At Reed, it was just the opposite. I remember a high point in my Reed experience was racing drunkenly through the campus of Lewis and Clark, another college across the river from Reed, with all three professors in the Department of Psychology. I was thinking, holy mackerel, if we had an accident, we'd just totally wipe out the psych department. I remember struggling under one of my many old junker cars, trying to replace a muffler and having the chair of the department, psych department, come by and crawl under the car with me and give me a hand putting the muffler in place. And it was very much like what I encountered in my brief experience with University of Oregon Graduate School in psychology, where I spent a trimester before being captured by the Army. I was drafted November 57 and taken to Fort Lewis, Washington, where I did basic training and then shipped directly to Fort Sam Houston, Texas, and San Antonio, the country of Texas, where I was an attendant on the locked psychiatric unit where soldiers and their dependents were taken if they had some sort of psychiatric emergency or situation. It was a useful experience, although I loathed and despised being in Texas, and it was kind of a reprise of being back in Fallsington. I could have, if I had wanted, gone in as an officer, but I would have had to spend a longer time, and was given an early discharge so I could attend medical school in Philadelphia.